Hello friends, now we see the subtopic 6 which include theorem of limits of chapter limits. The theorem is limit x tends to a x raise n minus a raise n whole thing divided by x minus a and that equal to n into a raise n minus 1 comma for all n belongs to set of natural number provided a is greater than 0. Now let's see the proof. The proof is quite simple. Let L that represent limit x tends to a x raise n minus a raise n upon x minus a. Now put x is equal to a plus h as x tends to a comma h tend to 0. So the next step will be L is equal to limit h tends to 0. Now whenever x we have to write a plus h, so we get a plus h whole bracket raise n minus a raise n totally divide by, again for x we substitute a plus h and the next term is minus a. Now that equal to limit h tends to 0. Now a plus h whole bracket raise n, this can be simplified by using binomial theorem. So the next step will be a raise n plus n into a raise n minus 1 into h plus n minus 1 upon 2 factorial a raise n minus 2 into x square plus going on and the last term is h raise n. So this is answer for the bracket a plus h whole bracket raise n and then minus the next term is a raise n that we write as it is and the whole thing is divided by. Now here if you observe plus a and minus a we can cancel in the denominator, so we left with only h in the denominator. Now again if you observe here, so we can cancel plus a raise n and minus a raise n. And from the remaining terms, we take h common. So the next step will be, so that equal to limit h tends to 0, h in bracket, we have n into a raise n minus 1 plus n minus 1 upon 2 factorial into a raise n minus 2 into h plus going on and the last term is h raise n minus 1 and the whole thing divide by h. Now here we cancel h from numerator and denominator. So the next step will be limit h tends to 0 n into a raise n minus 1 plus n into n minus 1 upon 2 factorial into a raise n minus 2 into h plus up to the last term is h raise n minus 1. And in bracket we mention since h tends to 0 and therefore h can't take value 0. It means here we cancel h from numerator and denominator. Now the next step, whenever h, we have to substitute limit as h tends to 0. So we get n into a raise n minus 1 plus n into n minus 1 upon 2 factorial into a raise n minus 2 into 0 plus the terms going on, and for last term, that is h raise n minus 1, we substitute 0 for h, so we get 0 raise n minus 1, that is 0. So the next step will be n into a raise n minus 1 plus, now 0 multiplied by n minus 1 upon 2 factorial into a raise n minus 2, so that again gives 0, the next term also 0, up to the last term is also 0. So in this way we get n into a raise n minus 1, and therefore limit x tends to a x raise n minus a raise n upon x minus a, that equal to n into a raise n minus 1 for all n belongs to set of natural number provided a is greater than 0. Now this result also we can use for non-zero rational numbers also. So one remark we have to mention here. The result also holds good for non-zero rational number n. So this is all about the theorem of limits. Thank you.